My science teacher said that if I could find a video and bring in the equipment to make a bottle rocket, that we could do it. Couldn't find a video, so I'm gonna make one. Challenge accepted.
The main thing to know about rockets, or in this case rocket propellant, is that it's mainly just a few components mixing together violently, or in this case more explosively. There are mainly two types of rocket boosters, FLBs or SRBs, solid rocket boosters and liquid fuel boosters. Today we're going to be focusing on liquid fuel boosters. A liquid fuel booster uses mainly two types of components. Something like a NASA rocket uses both liquid hydrogen and a liquid oxidizer to mix together to create an explosive reaction, creating water and an explosion that propels the rocket forward. Today we're going to be focusing on two different compounds, sodium bicarbonate and acetic acid.
I don't mean acetic acids, I mean acetic acids. The main difference is an acetic acid, or acidity, is anything that has a lower pH than 7. That makes the liquid acidic. An acetic acid is an organic compound created by acetobacteria during the fermenting process of alcohol into vinegar.
Or baking soda and vinegar.
Now, the first thing that we need to do to create a bottle rocket is we need to get our perfect rocket fuel. So now you need to see how much baking soda and how much the amount of vinegar affects how explosive the reaction is. So the way that we're going to be doing that is we're going to have a series of tests. So we have our four beakers, and what we're going to do is we're going to put a certain amount of baking soda and a certain amount of vinegar in each of them. Because it's mainly just one of the components, we're going to have a constant in all of them. So we're going to have 2 teaspoons of vinegar in all of them. Then we're going to vary the amount of baking soda for each one. So the first one is going to be 2 parts vinegar and 1 part baking soda. The second one is going to be 4 parts vinegar and 1 part baking soda. And then if it proves that the more vinegar there is, the more explosive the reaction, then we're gonna try and go with more. But if it's the opposite, then we're going to do one part, so 1 part vinegar and 1 part baking soda. And then if that works more, then we're gonna go with 1 part vinegar and then 2 parts baking soda. But first to do that, we're gonna transfer over to my workstation. All right, let's start testing. First, we're gonna try out 2 parts vinegar and 1 part baking soda. Going to mark where it went to. Now we're gonna go empty and clean out our beaker. Now we're gonna test out 4 parts vinegar and 1 part baking soda. Okay, so it was an average about right here. So currently 2 parts vinegar and 1 part baking soda is in the lead. And now we are going to try 1 part and 1 part. Wow. That's pretty high. That was quite high. So we have a new lead. It's 1 part and 1 part. So now we're going to see if the factor that's determining how high it is the amount of sodium bicarbonate. So we're going to go clear out this tube, and we're going to try 2 parts sodium and 1 part vinegar. Alrighty. Alright. So we have determined that there is such a thing as too much sodium bicarbonate. So we're going to see if 1 part vinegar and 1.5 parts sodium bicarbonate will do the trick. Now, if we get this right, we should have a sweet spot, and this should be our highest thing. If it is not, then we're going to try 1 1/4 part. All right. Takes the lead. We have found our perfect, almost, serum to a good rocket fuel for making a
vinegar, and baking soda powered rocket.
We're currently out of sodium bicarbonate and acetic acid, so we're going over to my local CVS to get some baking soda and some vinegar. But while we do that, I want to take some time to explain to you Newton's third law of motion. Newton's third law of motion states that anything that has a reaction will have both an equal and opposite reaction. So if I push on something with a certain amount of force, that object will then push back with that same amount of force. That's why when you push on Jell-O, it bounces back. So we can actually use this law of motion to help propel certain objects. In this case, I'm going to show you how it works with the trebuchet.
So the way that this trebuchet works is it has a beam which holds one weight on one side of it. Then it has a little carriage which you put a ball into, and then you attach a string to the end of this. So when we take this side of the beam and pull it down, we're then loading this weight with a lot of potential energy. And then we just attach this side, we attach this little washer to the end of this beam, and then we load a ball into here, and then we drop this side, and then all that potential energy is transferred into kinetic energy, and it drops, and then it loads its opposite reaction, so it launches this end while this end goes down, this end goes up, and then eventually this washer will fly off of this, launching this little piece of felt forward, launching the ball in turn.
Alright, so we take our ball, we put it into this piece of felt, then we load this washer on top of this little wire, then we pull back the beam, loading up the weight with potential energy, and then launch it.
Alright, now let's go get our baking soda and vinegar. Alrighty, they were all out of baking soda. I was able to get my vinegar though, so I shall search my house for any leftover baking soda. But first, it's lunchtime. Can I order one cheese tandoori?
One?
Yep.
About 10 minutes.
All right, thank you.
This stuff tastes good, but it'll give you a heart attack.
Alright, so there's one slight problem. I never told you guys how bottle rockets actually work. And for that, to build a bottle rocket, I feel that you guys should know. So the way that any bottle rocket works is that it's all about pressure. There is no bottle rocket that you can make that is about burning and making an explosion that propels it forward. The whole thing is that a chemical reaction happens inside of the bottle, and some sort of plug obstructing the nozzle where the gas could go out is blocked. So eventually the pressure inside the bottle builds up enough that it blows out that blockage, launching the bottle rocket up with all the remaining pressure and liquid coming out of the bottom. So the way that we're gonna do this is we're gonna start by putting our baking soda and vinegar inside of the bottle. We're gonna put around a tablespoon of each, and then we're gonna stuff it up with a cork or some type of plug. Then we're gonna shake it and invert it. And then eventually, once we leave the site after 5 seconds, it will pop the cork and it will start flying. I'm estimating about 10 feet. Now, the only two problems that we have with this is that we don't have a cork or something to block it, and we don't have any landing gear or anything. You're supposed to use a pencil or something rigid so that it stands up, but I feel that with the size of our water bottle and the amount of material we can get in there to create propulsion, I don't know if it's gonna be enough because the pencils might weigh it down too much. But first, let's take into account the cork problem. So now we have two options. I do have this wine bottle cork, but the only problem is it doesn't really fit inside of the water bottle. So now there's two options. We can use this wine bottle cork and put some duct tape around the edges and try and stuff it in that way. Or we can make some hot glue, put it onto the edge of this cap and make our own blockage. Now the best course of action to do is to test all your options. So let's start with the cork. Alright, so I think I've found our first solution.
The only thing that I have to say is that it comes out a bit too easily, so we might want to put another layer of duct tape on it, or just go with it. Now let's try our second solution. It was way too viscous and sticky to be able to properly try and use it as a solution. So rather than continue on this topic, to get it out of here. Clean that mess up. Alright, so the way that I'm gonna fix my landing gear problem is rather than trying to make landing gear on top of the rocket itself, or rather on the bottom, I'm going to make a launch pad using some wire coat hangers and make almost like a spiral at the top where you can place in this. Have made our perfect launch pad. Not perfect, not at all perfect. This is very, very crude. We do have a few leaks on the cork, but I mean, nothing a little duct tape can't fix. Bada bing, bada boom, we're done. But yeah, let's go test it. So I just forgot the launch pad at home, so we're going to bike back home and get the launch pad back, so I'll be right back. I got it. Let's go. Once I put the vinegar and baking soda in here, I'll plug it up, and then the pressure will build up inside of this, eventually leading it to pop the cork out and fly up. Or, in this case, what we say is, hopefully. So. We have our baking soda in here, and we have a lot of baking soda on the ground because it's very hard to do this. So, let's get our hand vinegar open. Not even know if it's gonna explode.
kind of exploded
before it got to it.
So now we know that it works. We just have to be way faster. Let's get a remainder in there. If this doesn't work, then we failed.
After many failed attempts, I began to lose hope, but eventually, something happened. I plugged the water bottle just like the others. Filled with baking soda and vinegar, I plugged it up and set it down on a launch pad. Then it worked. The cork popped out. It flew! It wasn't like the others. It was better than them. All the others that had come before him. Mark 1 and 2. It wasn't like the others. It flew. It flew so high. It flew 6 feet. It was one of the high. It was one of the greatest achievements of all time. As you can tell by the music.
Baking soda in there, then it would be much bigger, much taller, much more explosive. But you know, that bottle rocket didn't work, but you know, we had C-class motor, C65. We're gonna glue that into the side of this bottle rocket. It's gonna shoot up. This stuff goes high. This is the stuff you see in the model rockets. We got our launcher here. You know it's real when you got the key to put into the pad. Uh-huh. Yeah, we're about to do that. Alrighty. We have our rocket. We're just gonna attach some landing legs to it, and then we'll fire it. Alrighty, so we have our bottle set up with our C-class motor. We have everything hooked up. We are going to bring our launch key, mini launch pad over here. Straighten this puppy out. Alrighty. Appears we did not press it hard enough last time. There we go. Smells like gunpowder and sulfur and rotten eggs.